Hey guys, welcome back to another Streamline Connector tutorial. This is Santi, and in today's video, we will be going over the raise a ticket workflow. So in order to get started, first you will need to connect to your ticketing platform, which could be Gorgias, Freshdesk, or Zendesk. Big shout out to Dan and the Voiceflow team. Here in this sticky new note that you see on the screen, you have their video linked in case you wanna know more about the function. So let's navigate to the right bottom corner. And here you will have the three different platforms. What you need to do here is connect. In this case, we'll be using Freshdesk to the correct step. In this case, you will need to set the yes path and the email capture. So when both are connected, you need to go to the function step, click on it, and then you will need to enter your subdomain and your API key. As if you hover over the variable names, you will find a little description explaining what is each variable. In this case, for example, the subdomain of streamlineconnector.freshdesk.com would be just Streamline Connector. So let's enter that. And then our API key. Just go ahead and paste that. And that is it. Lastly, you will need to connect the success path to this first message that tells the user that the ticket was successfully submitted, and the error path that tells them likewise. So regarding the setting up, that is it. So let's see how the new search, knowledge-based search, and the prompt step works. We try to reduce the amount of tickets you get, and in order to do that, we created a little process before submitting the ticket to allow the chatbot to look up for solutions in your knowledge base. So, for example, here I added a very simple plain text file which tells the bot what to do when the drone is not charging properly. So let's see how that works. In case the solution wasn't found, it will continue with the submitting a ticket process without even mentioning. So my drone is not charging properly. What you will see here is a list of steps suggesting what the user what to do for this case. As you can see here, we have many steps. For example, check charger connection, verify power supply, inspect charging cable, and so on. It also tells the user that if they are not happy with the solution, they can click the submit my ticket button and they can continue with the process. So let me show you how the workflow looks like when it doesn't find the solution. So let's say, for example, in this case that I got the delivered, sorry. I got delivered the wrong drone, which it is quite a common case. So as you can see, we have no documentation for it, so it didn't find a solution. So it proceeded with the creating a ticket process. So how should I call it? It is asking for my name. I'm Santi. And then it will ask for the email. We enter the email. And now it's going to create my ticket. So as you can see here in the debug mode, the ticket priority was set to 2 in this case, which is medium for Freshdesk. And let's go over to Freshdesk and we should have the ticket here. Yeah, here incorrect drum delivered replacement request. And if you enter the ticket, you here you have the message that I sent to the bot. So that is it on the Raise a Ticket workflow. I hope you like it. In case you have questions, please leave them in the comment box. See you on the next one.